income communities like full-service grocery stores where they can enjoy high-quality produce such as fresh fruits, vegetables, whole wheat, and low-fat dairy products. They may be limited to shopping at small convenience stores where these options may not be as available. Residents in neighborhoods who have a better access to supermarkets tend to have an overall healthier diet and a lower rate in obesity. Martin Luther King Jr. speaks on the unfair circumstances in his speech, Letters to Birmingham Jail. He claims the government is simply waiting for a more convenient season to intervene and offer the support needed for these areas. Urbanization has also affected the produce distributed to the public because an increased amount of people leads to an increased amount of land needed for these people, and this leads to the destruction of farmland. In this graph provided by the California Climate and Agriculture Network, you can see as the years have progressed, the amount of farmland loss has increased. And in a 2002 American Farmland Trust report, it was found that an average of 400,000 acres of farmland was converted into urbanized areas in the years 1980 to the 1990s. And the main reason for the destruction of farmland is the migration of people from cities to more suburb areas. And due to this, this leads to the prices of produce increasing, which thus affects consumers' diets, because this leads to them not being as able to get the fresh produce they need. So why should we care about the change of the American diet? Because they can have many long-term negative health effects, such as obesity, depression, diabetes, stroke, cancer, and can even lead to an earlier death. There also has been a rapid rise in obesity. According to the National Bureau of Economic Research, it was found that obesity in the U.S. has risen tremendously since the 1970s. The percent of children from ages 6 to 19 classified as overweight has tripled from 5% to now 17%. And for the adults, it now has found that one-third of the population to now one-half of the population is struggling with obesity. And so after looking at what factors change the American diet, this leads me to my research question, which is, to what extent should the American diet be changed to result in positive health implications? My first solution would be for the Department of Education to require cookery and nutrition classes taught in all schools, and they will be taught along the Universal Food Pyramid as their guide. Here's a picture of the Universal Food Pyramid provided by the U.S. Department of Agriculture. As you can see, it is a very simple pyramid that simply says what to eat more and less of. However, there is a limitation to this, meaning this food pyramid has been widely criticized. According to Dr. Wallet Willett, who is a Harvard scientist, he claims that this pyramid is not up to date with current nutrition research. He also claims there's actually 6 faults in this pyramid, which is leading Americans to further health damage instead of improving their diets. The food pyramid also does not elaborate on the exercise and weight control needed for a healthy lifestyle. It simply says recommendations on foods and diets, and this will not give them the best possible health results. The implications of this is this would target obesity at a young age, since this would be taught in school, and children would learn healthy eating habits, which will help them in the future and as they turn into adults. My second solution would be to introduce and adopt a new pyramid called the Healthy Eating Pyramid. The Healthy Eating Pyramid was created by the Harvard School of Public Health in 2008. This would be provided to consumers when entering a grocery store, and this can be advertised in multiple ways, whether it be signs on the aisles in the grocery store, printed on the back of shopping carts, or even paper copies that can be available to the customers as they walk in. Here is a picture of the Healthy Eating Pyramid provided by the Harvard T.H. Chan, and as you can see, this pyramid is far more complex and offers a wide variety of recommendations of food that one should eat. Australia adopted the Healthy Eating Pyramid in 2015, and Nutrition Australia claims that this provides more information on the type and proportions of foods that we should eat daily. And it is making it easier than ever for families to make informed decisions in regarding their diet. The limitation to this is some Americans may still choose to ignore the healthy eating pyramid even when it is advertised and provided for them. There also is a lack of successful evidence and statistic from the Australian Healthy Eating Pyramid. Here's a comparison between the two pyramids, and as you can see, the Healthy Eating Pyramid suggests the limits of refined grains, red meats, and dairy. And also, at the bottom of the pyramid, it's heavily recommended daily exercise and weight control, and this shifts to a more plant-based diet. Implications of this is this will provide Americans with reliable, up-to-date information on a healthy lifestyle, which is backed by Harvard scientists, and this gives recommendations on exercise and weight control for the best possible healthy outcome. And this will lead consumers to make well-informed decisions when they're grocery shopping or when they're going out to eat with fast food restaurants. So if the federal government adopted the Healthy Eating Pyramid, obesity rates would decrease due to the public being well-informed on the Healthy Eating Pyramid, and this would result in an overall healthy lifestyle. Thank you, and here is my work cited.
Okay, so the first question, what evidence did you gather that you didn't use, and why did you choose not to use it?
The evidence that I gathered that I decided not to include in my research was I found in when I was doing my economic lens what type of artificial foods they put in fast food, whether it be saturated fats and artificial flavoring, and I found how that affected the American diet, but I decided not to use that because I wanted to go in more of the direction of not how health is affected, but how the people and have affected their health and how the environment has been affected by that.
Thank you. And then the next question, what advice would you have for other researchers who consider this topic?
The advice that I would recommend for researchers who want to do this is really find out how the American diet has changed over the years by researching the diet for the average American in the 1950s and then comparing it to the 2000. And from there, you can decide which factors most significantly change the diet